Have you ever wondered how we look and are so different from ancient cavemen or even our great ape relatives? Our lineage dives back centuries across millions of different animals, but how did we become human? Well, the answer to this is evolution. In fact, it is hypothesized that all species evolved from Luca, or the last common ancestor, who was a form of anaerobic bacteria. But how exactly did Luca evolve into the vast range of life on Earth? This is a question that plagued geneticists for years, but now it is commonly accepted that changes, or mutations, in the genetic code drive evolution. Over millions of years that life has existed, these mutations have created the diversity present on Earth, such as us. Understanding this was revolutionary for understanding biology, but Japanese geneticist Susumu Ohno thought that there had to be more to this phenomenon and that such complex diversity couldn't have just developed through such small-scale mutations. As such, Ohno proposed duplication of the entire genome of vertebrates and eventually landed on his 2R hypothesis, in that there were two rounds of entire genome duplication in vertebrate evolution. In the words of Ohno, whole genome duplication occurs in one fell swoop, meaning that all regulatory regions of the gene alongside all of the genetic content are duplicated simultaneously. This process was coined by the term polyploidy. Polyploidy maintains the stability of the genome, and the duplication of DNA creates more base pairs and therefore allows for twice the amount of mutation. This opens a door for huge amounts of differentiation and genetic variability, which is thought to have resulted in the huge diversity amongst vertebrates. Ohno wrote a whole book on this phenomenon, Evolution by Gene Duplication, which has such driven a variety of additional evolutionary research, an example of which being an investigation into Fugu, or pufferfish, evolution. Researchers at the Institute of Molecular and Cell Biology worked alongside researchers at the University of Cambridge to answer the question, how has whole genome duplication affected the evolution of teleosts, specifically Fugu? Teleosts are an evolutionary group of ray-finned fish that encompasses over 24,000 marine species and that originally evolved from lobed-finned fishes. These researchers chose to work on Fugu genomes as they have the smallest and most compact genome of the teleosts, making it easier to analyse. Prior to this, it was established that teleosts had almost double the number of clustered Hox genes than what was present in mammalian species. Hox genes drive the development of body plans, and as such the additional Hox clusters in teleosts pose the question, did and when exactly did teleosts experience whole genome duplication? As such, these scientists propose that either a whole genome duplication occurred before the teleost separated from the lobe-finned fish, or that it occurred after and independently in different lineages. To test this, they compared the genome of the Fugu to the human genome and searched for paralogons, which are sets of genes that are from a common ancestor. Numerous paralogons are evidence of whole genome duplication and as such are a key part of figuring out this conundrum. These scientists used numerous computer programs to visualize the sequence of both the Fugu and human genome, and to therefore search for paralogous regions between the genomes. In total, 468 paralogous regions were found, which spanned 6.6% of the entire Fugu genome. As such, they were able to confidently determine that whole genome duplication did in fact occur. However, this does not fully answer their question, with these scientists then constructing a figurative molecular clock to estimate when this duplication occurred. This clock isn't really a clock, but rather is a way to use the average mutation rate to infer when species diverged. Using this method, they concluded that teleosts experienced whole genome duplication prior to their separation from lobe-finned fishes around 350 million years ago, as such proving their first hypothesis. Although this all might sound a little bit irrelevant to you, understanding evolution is so important in learning how to better deal with our changing world. Phenomena such as surviving climate changes, bacterial antibiotic resistance, and extinction are all evolutionarily based. Understanding all the ways in which evolution works helps us to be able to use evolution in our favour. Using this research and methods, another group of scientists discovered that whole genome duplication occurs in 30% of cancer-causing tumours, which allows them to account for this in their cancer treatment and to eventually develop treatments to prevent this duplication and ideally tumour growth. Now, this is all very theoretical and a long way in our future, but understanding these things now is integral for our species. So who knows? Maybe one day your great-great-great-grandchildren will have double the DNA that you do.